What happened?
The thing broke. This show snapped on me.
The unreliable chairs.
Almost ruined your book, darn Tori.
Not even funny.
Hi, I'm Dr. Halstead. What can I do for you?
Little hook shot. Oh, Halstead. But it got stuck.
What are you doing?
Huh?
What are you doing?
Eating nuts. Damn, I just... If I could find Tori DeVito, I just...
You can find us tonight on an all-new Chicago Med!
I'm not participating. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Tori. Action. Tori?
Yeah.
It's almost time.
Time for what?
I think you know.
Today?
Tonight.
Tonight? The night?
9, 8 Central.
Shit.
At 9, NBC.
NBC Chicago Med.
We work on that show.
Right.
I'm
yeah.
so happy. So do you.
I am happy.
Sometimes, and thankfully, not often, we'll have a patient come through our doors and there is just no hope. We don't have the supplies, the stamina, frankly, the staff to help this person. But I do have the hair. You know, as a real fake doctor, the number one thing that gets under my epidermis is the lack of conversation around the importance of perfect hair. I mean, from the moment I walk into a patient's room, they're already smelling the product I use. That alone eases them. I can see a physical, visceral reaction to it, and that makes me feel good. The style is the next most important thing to me. In fact, it probably takes the cake. It allows aerodynamic through these halls when I have to move swiftly for an emergency. And I catch people looking. Jealousy is a stinky cologne. To those aspiring real and fake professionals, I want to let you know that with some hard work, I mean hard work, and a little dab of magic move, your hair too could be like mine. Not quite like mine, but close.
Are you still working?